thank you for coming to this 33rd annual concerto concert. I just want to have you know that this started in 1992, and so it's been an annual tradition for, you know, these 33 years. Tonight you'll hear soloist Cassidy Sakamoto, Ian Ahn, and Conrad Cao. Before each solo, you will see a short video of each soloist and hear how music has transformed their lives. But before we begin tonight's concert, I would like to acknowledge those who have helped with the production of the concert. First, I'd like to recognize Mr. Michael Lippard, Academy Music Department Head, Mrs. Chris Ann Sills, Music Department Secretary, and Mrs. Helen Chow Cassano, Director of the Punahou Music School, for coordinating all the details for this concert. So Dr. Carlson and myself didn't have to worry about anything else except getting the music ready. I'd like to thank Mr. Andrew Ryan, the Director of Video Production, and his students of the Punahou Vision Production who helped make tonight's live stream possible. Claire Treviso and Travis Flazer of the Dillingham Theater for their assistance, and Sean Alterado for our audio and video help. We'd also like to thank the students and alumni of the University of Hawaii Music Department, as well as some music instructors at Punahou who are playing in our wind and brass section and percussion section tonight. So I hope you enjoy tonight's concert. Thank you.
Thank you. I think music's always been a pretty big part of my life. I've always, when I was really little, like heard my dad playing the guitar and singing. But I think my first real instrument that I started was the piano when I was around in kindergarten. Well, I'd always wanted to play the violin, but the summer before fifth grade, I finally got the chance to join like a beginning summer orchestra. And I remember hearing the demonstration that Miss Lawton did on the first day of all the instruments. And I heard the viola and I just really fell in love with its sound. Music for me has just been a great way to express my creativity. I love being creative, and along with like viola and orchestra, I also really like to write my own music and try to produce stuff on like my laptop and learn new instruments like the guitar. I want to learn like the drums and bass sometimes. And with that, it's just, I feel like with any idea or story I have in my head, I can kind of take that in any direction I want, and I have the freedom to really create. I'm also probably the most grateful for my parents who've, you know, always been there to support me in my music. And my dad has been, you know, really big musical inspiration and role model for me, while my mom has always been the one to like take me to all my rehearsals, and she was even like a youth symphony concert parent, and so she would have to show up to all the rehearsals and concerts, and been very grateful for that. So I'm playing the Elgar Cello Concerto, the first movement, and I think the main reason I chose this is because I just really love how dramatic it sounds. It was written in 1919, right after World War I, and so it really conveys the range of emotions felt during that time. You can hear like the grief and desperation, but then there's also like those moments of kind of hope or romance that shine through, and I really appreciate that about the piece. This is something that I've kind of always like aspired to. It's just really cool to be able to play a piece that I like genuinely love, and especially since the viola doesn't usually get kind of the melody, this is a really cool and unique experience for me. I'm definitely very grateful for my viola teacher, Dr. Hamano, who's guided me for all these years, and for all the Punahou conductors, also all the symphony conductors I've had. I think they've really driven my appreciation for classical music and for being in like a symphony.
I started when I was 5 years old, and I played for a few years, and then I took a long break, and when I came to Hawaii from Korea, I restarted when I was 11 years old. I came to Punahou in ninth grade, and I started doing orchestra right away, and then from sophomore year, I was part of the symphony orchestra and quartet as well. My parents took me to every single rehearsal, every single recitals or practices, and takes dedication. And you know, it's like I don't live in a big house, so it's like my dad can hear me practicing, and it doesn't sound nice 90% of the time, and you know, he tolerated that, and so I thank him for that. I used to be not that consistent with my practices, but I realized, you know, it doesn't have to be so boring all the time, and I try to make, just even if it's just 30 minutes of sitting down and doing it, I try to mix it up and try to make it fun. This concerto was composed by Saint-Saëns, and in I believe 1872, and this was right after the French-German War, so there was little German influence in there. And this was Saint-Saëns' first cello concerto, and it was a big hit right away. And yeah, I chose this piece because it kind of goes through a variety of emotions, and such as, you know, excitement, love, joy, longing, sadness. It's all kind of in there, so I thought it was a good piece to play.
When I was five, in our apartment, we had a old digital piano, a Casio, and I would always be kind of just playing on it, not really any piece in particular since I didn't know how to play yet. But when my parents saw this, they encouraged me to take lessons. So I'm definitely very grateful for my piano teachers. Mrs. Joshi, she pretty much laid a very sound foundation for me, and Mrs. Bichuan Lee, and Dr. Yi as well. Of course, Dr. Carlson, Mr. Young, and Mrs. Cassano, my parents, for supporting me throughout all of these years and getting me into the musical journey in the first place. And last but not least, my sister, for just always being a cheerleader for me on the sidelines. Well, Mrs. Lee first proposed the Rhapsody in Blue to me, and I gave it a listen, and I also did try it out. And I found that it was very different from what I was used to. Instead of romantic repertoire, Gershwin is very contemporary. And I thought that it was a way to, I guess, express another side of me, since I think people usually view me as quiet or calm, and the Gershwin definitely contrasts that. So I think once I heard it and got the experience to actually try it out, I think it just really connected with me and was really resounding, and I was very excited to play it. The main thing I've learned is overcoming hardships. I think it's really helped me to get through these stressful situations. I've gotten really frustrated with many of my pieces, and a lot of times I felt like I wanted to quit. But I think piano has really taught me to power through it, especially rewarding me with the experience to play the piece at the end. I think that's made it all the more fulfilling. I've known about the concerto for some time, and it has always been a dream for me to be able to play with especially such an amazing orchestra. And I think that I was really excited to have this opportunity to one, express myself, but also continue playing with my friends.
Thank you. Thank you.